So first I'm going to let myself play a few of the first sounds that came out of the breadboard version of the Arduino. Later on, I added in some light-dependent resistors, which kind of work like a theremin control, which I find really interesting. They're actually the start of the CV Vactrols, which you'll see later on in the video. You're basically adding an LED to the other side, which is controlled by an external voltage. It's very similar to this process, actually. It's just done automatically. So here's a bit of the weird stuff that came out of that. So the next thing to do after building it on the breadboard was to figure out how to make a permanent version. I haven't ever done anything like this before, so it was quite a project. I probably went about it in a bit of a inefficient way, but I still like it. So I got all the pieces you need, which is basically a stripboard, four audio jacks, five potentiometers, and the Arduino Nano, as well as a few LEDs. So I measured out where I'd like them to go in this little biscuit box I found in my boyfriend's house. And I didn't even have the right size drill bits, which wasn't helpful. But I managed to make things work in the end with a combination of screwing and mashing my pieces and using sandpaper. It all fit in the end, so I decided that was good enough. So I went and got some acrylic paint from the corner of the room, basically, and started to put that on top of this biscuit box wood. So after that dried, I obviously had to start assembling everything. So I get the audio jacks and screw them in. And then obviously get the potentiometers as well, put them in, and just get everything facing the right way so that I can have something organized to solder from. I also forgot to put the hole for the LED, which was not a good move, because I kind of messed up the wood by drilling it a bit late. But that's fine, you can't really see it, it's fine. So, there we go, it looks alright. So this is the Vactrol CV thingy. So first I filed off the end of the LED just so that they would sit nicely against each other. It is plastic, so it's not dangerous. You then want to make them as isolated from light as possible using something. I used electrical tape. Heat shrink might be better, anything is probably better, but electrical tape worked. It just took forever because I made all these weird little X-shaped things and wrapped it around, and it worked in the end, so they look kind of cool. Yeah. So yeah, just wrote on the information about what all the bits did on the front. And yeah, so I had to make the hole for the power supply for the Arduino, which was actually more of an issue than it should have been, because I really didn't have the right drill to be making a hole for a USB plug. But I got there in the end. And so yeah, this is the stripboard. I have to separate the two sides of it because it has basically rows along it so that there is a connection outwards from each pin. But if you keep them connected in the middle, it causes a bit of an issue because you're basically connecting both sides of the Arduino, which is going to cause a lot of issues and probably short it. I was starting to get a bit confused by this point, so I decided to make a few notes in my book, which were probably a little bit overcomplicated because I hadn't learned how to do circuit diagrams at this point. I'm not sure I even know how to now, really. But so yeah, this kind of helped me figure out where everything was going on the breadboard and what I'd need to do when I did start soldering. Unfortunately, when I was first soldering, the tip was a bit damaged, so I was having a lot of issues here getting things to work. But yeah, here we go, here's the new one, and it's working really nicely. So I'm just soldering the Arduino Nano board on right now, which was actually a lot easier than I expected it to be. It looks incredibly fiddly, but as long as you're not using too much solder, it seems to kind of want to fall in the right place. So I appreciated that. It wasn't too bad. Use sticky back Velcro to attach it to the wood, just so it had a little bit of isolation between it and the floor. So yeah, I put a resistor on one leg of the LED just to make sure it didn't blow out. And I'm connecting both sides of the input on the audio jacks because I don't need them to be stereo, I need them to be mono. And then they're getting connected to the potentiometer, but that's the power that's getting connected to the potentiometer. So we're basically connecting all the power together right now to make sure everything is receiving power. And then obviously you want to plug that into the 5-volt pin on the Arduino so that it's sending power to everything. So for these CV inputs, you basically want to connect the positive leg of the LED through a resistor to the audio, to the sort of signal pin on the audio inputs, and then you want to get the negative leg and connect that to the ground. So that's what's giving you that electrical isolation, because that LED there is controlled solely by the voltage coming through the audio input, or the CV input really. And that allows you to control it using other things without potentially risking the circuit inside. So at the moment, the pink wires are connecting that negative leg to the ground, and I'm just soldering everything together. It's a little bit difficult to explain, and it honestly took me a few days to understand. There's a few people who really helped me. I'm going to link a few people in the description who were really, really helpful. This is honestly the most complicated part of this circuit, and it's completely not necessary. I just want to try and build some sort of modular thing. I don't know what's going to happen yet, but this is step number one, and hopefully I'll be doing a sequencer soon. We'll see what happens with that. This white wire here is connecting the positive leg of the LED to the control pin on the Arduino, which is basically allowing the Arduino to choose when it lights up. The blue wire is connecting the potentiometer to one of the analog inputs on the Arduino. Each potentiometer has its own wire for this, and it's basically allowing the Arduino to receive the information that you're giving it when you turn those potentiometers. So I'm using the Arduino software at the moment, which was written by Peter Knight back in, I'm not even sure when, but I've seen it on websites from 2009. It works pretty well, but he seems to have disappeared from the internet, so it's quite interesting to work on, to be honest. So thank you, Peter Knight, if there's any reason you'd see this. Yeah, put that back in the box, see if it still closes. It seems to close just about. But I hadn't actually connected everything together. I'd forgotten to put some of the ground wires in, so I panickedly went back and did that before I plugged it in. Just finishing the soldering. Right, so this is the first time I plugged it in. It all seems to be working okay. The light turns on, but the issue is I'm not getting any sound through the amplifier at all, which is not really a good sign. So I start messing around in the software, doing all sorts of things, wondering what on earth I've done wrong, before I notice I literally didn't plug the audio output into the digital output on the Arduino. So that's what this white wire is doing. It's basically allowing the Arduino to send any sound to the audio output. So kind of an important wire. So here we go. I'm going to plug it in and see what we got here. I think I might have put a short in it somewhere when I was using that broken soldering iron, because some wires don't work very well in it. But this little blue wire seems to work fine, so I'm gonna plug that in and have a see what the first sounds I got out of this thing sound like. At this point I realised I hadn't actually connected the power between all of the potentiometers, so they weren't working. Only the first one was working, so I went in and fixed that. So yeah, just going to solder all of those together so that they're actually powered, which seems fairly important. And now let's have a listen to what it sounds like with all of the bits working.